right. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Kimmo Lönnmark. I'm CEO of Privanet Securities. Sorry about the loud music. It's nice to hear it once we have made it. Privanet, what we are doing, so we are connecting investors who are seeking profits and of course the SMEs who are seeking finance for themselves. Nothing new, but still something what you have to do in this world because you don't get enough funding from the banks at the moment. The entrepreneurs in Finland and also in other countries are in trouble seeking that funding. About the Privanet itself, it was established in year 2000. We are quite similar old company like companies in Sweden, I think Mangold and NGM and Axytoriet and companies like that are quite similar old companies. Also Pepins is, I think, 2001 established. We have quite funny history because 2003 we had in our marketplace a company called HEX. It was Helsinki Stock Exchange, and it was sold to OMX to Sweden from our list. We have plenty of nice history here. Then we also had IPO for Tallink from Privanet. And then 2007, we were the First North certified advisor in Finland also. And our new second coming from Privanet starts from 2011 when our new company called Navi Group was established. And same time, I joined the board 2013 to the old Privanet Group. And that moment, there was two companies, Navi Group and Privanet, and we didn't know each other. But 2015, Navi Group started to be interested about the Privanet, and they bought us. And that moment, the whole group changed its name to Privanet Group. And after that, it has been a very successful story together. 2016, we opened our first equity-based crowdfunding platform called Around, which was the video in the first place. So we are running after the money for the companies. That's the idea of the story. And then we were also listed to the First North in same year in June 2016. And 2017, it has been also very lots of happenings. So we bought one third of Funded by Me Finland. So we are now having that brand also in Finland, and we can also use that in Baltics. And then we established also our loan-based crowdfunding platform called Realinvest. And then one of the greatest and latest happened was that NGM and its parent company, Stuttgart Börse, they announced that they are buying 10% of the Privanet. And the first stake they have already purchased, so 5% is now owned by NGM. So what we are? So we are group of companies, and the main companies are Privanet Capital Markets, and also the second is Privanet Securities. Those two companies, they are FSA-regulated companies, and we can also use this MiFID license to sell our products also in other EU countries. So we have passported our license to do this to all 28 countries here in Europe. We are doing this business a little different than all the others. So same time when banks are they are not using any more local offices, so we are expanding our network. So at the moment, we have 12 local bases in Finland, and then we are now seeking new locations from other Nordic countries. So we are expanding our business quite rapidly. And about these companies, so the Privanet Securities is which I'm the CEO, and at the moment, Privanet Capital Markets owns 76% of our company, but we have announced that we are having a deal where Privanet Capital Markets and Privanet Groups, they are buying the management shares, and we are converting them to the Privanet Group. So In the end of this year, it will be 100% owned company, and the old management team owns just Privanet Group's shares, not the daughter company. So this is, in short, what we are doing. The old Privanet thing is the secondary markets. So we are the only secondary marketplace for the unlisted companies in Finland. And also, this is not useful. No, there are not so many companies which are doing this in all Europe. So I think in Finland and Sweden, there are just two companies or three companies who have the secondary markets for the unlisted companies. And this is changing all over the Europe because all the time, the crowdfunding, it makes new companies, and there are lots of investors who owns already maybe one or 10 or 20 companies, and they have to sell those companies in some states. Either they just need money or then they already get profit, so they want to sell from that reason. But still, secondary markets are needed. So this is the oldest thing what we are doing. Then we are also investing from our balance sheet. So every time when companies comes to speak with us, so we ask, of course, what you are doing and how much you are going to need money. And if it's something between 100,000-1 million euros, then we are able to invest from our balance sheet. So for the smallest ones, we are investing by ourselves, and then we are maybe improving the company and giving them advice, and after one or two years, we are going to raise more money for them from the investor side. So at that moment, of course, we get profits, but still we get the biggest risk also when we are investing in the first place. Then we are now doing also the real estate crowdfunding, so it's something below 20 million euros projects. Then the equity crowdfunding, this is little similar, not similar like in Sweden. In Finland, we have laws for the crowdfunding, so you can raise up to 5 million euros with equity crowdfunding, and you have to have this investment license in Finland. So that we have in Finland, and that was the main reason why we purchased the Funded by Me Finland, because Funded by Me couldn't come to Finland without this license. So that was the way why, how they could expand to Finland also with us. And also, we make those private placements, so something below 20 million. So we are looking the cases which are not big enough for the banks and for the family offices. So that's our main focus area. Those companies which signed those private placements, they are, we are owning those companies also, not the Prudentus, but Finlandia Innovestor, so we are doing quite close cooperations with them. So if it's, is it profitable business? Yes, this is very profitable business, of course. It has always been profitable to seek money for somebody, and if you are successful for raising money for somebody, some companies, those companies are willing to pay you. And the thing is that you have to be successful. So these are our three-year figures. So our revenues has been growing quite rapidly, and this year, I think we are making flat revenues, so something between 12 million-13 million euros. Sales, operating income is something what we have already estimated in the first note, so our estimate is 5.5 million euros profit for this year. The net income is the thing where you can see that this year, quite a lot of our profits came from the Privanet Securities. So, and that was the company where Privanet Group didn't own the whole company. So that was the reason why it started to shrink our net income from, for the whole group. So now when we are converting our shares to the group, so after that, group owns all the Privanet Securities, and all the profits comes to group, not to the daughter company. So that was the reason for this. Same time, what is also growing is our customer base, and of course this is one of the most important things that in Finland we have 1 million people who has shares in their own portfolios. At the moment Privatnet still has just 15,000 people, so we have quite a lot things to do there to achieve that 1 million people. But still these 15,000 people, they are very very good people, they are high worth individuals, so we are very proud of them, and that's the reason why we are so successful for raising money, because these people really can invest to the companies. And one thing is also that the employees, so 2016 when we were listed we had just 23 people in our group, at the moment we have 58. And last week when we have our company parties for the Christmas parties, so we had there 54 people joining, so that means that people are very close together, even we are all over the Finland, so people want to be together, and we have very good feeling in our company. So how is our company going in the First North at the moment? So last week wasn't not so impressive for us, as you can see from our share price from last week to this level. It is maybe 20% down in just 2 days. The reason was one of our investments called Lapis Rakennus, which is a real estate company. And the markets and analysts took it very hard that they were saying that, okay, this is very bad for Privanet that they have invested this company. We haven't said anything aloud at the moment, so I can't comment a lot about this, but what I can say is that this is our own investment balance sheet. So at the moment we have more than 40 companies where we have invested. So this Lapis was just one of our investments. And same time, this is one of our cases, Primoseller. This is just one example that we invested this case 14 months ago with pre-money value 4.5 million euros. And at the moment, the current valuation estimated 25 million euros. And of course, in our balance sheet, it is the purchase price, the 4.5 million euros, what is the company worth. So of course, there are upsides and sometimes there comes downsides for the company. So that's not big deal for us, but it seems that if you are in First North listed company, so people sometimes sell your company and sometimes they are buying. But if you are looking at our numbers from other side, so we are quite cheap company from that reason. Our PE number is 10 right now and dividend yield is 9%. So we have been very good dividend payer all the time. And I think our strategy is to continue that way. So we have always paid the 25 cents per share, and for this it's almost 10% dividend yield for the next year. And also here the peer-to-peer comparison, so you can see also that we are quite cheap at the moment. Return of our equity is more than 50%, so quite a lot. So something about our secondary market still, of course, like you can see from the pie here, is that there are bigger companies and smaller companies. So the biggest ones takes most of the volumes from our secondary markets. But the biggest companies are still also very big ones, so they should be in Nasdaq Helsinki at the moment. They are more worth than 1 billion euros companies. So they shouldn't be in our list. And what's the reason why they are in our list is that in Finland we have the dividend taxation policy which makes companies to stay unlisted if they don't need the listed markets. And also the second reason is that bureaucracy. So if you are not going to stock exchange, you don't have to have things like quarterly reports and things like that. So those companies, they don't just want to go to the listed markets. At the moment, or last year, we have 49 companies which were traded in our marketplace. And I think at the moment, for Privanet, the secondary market is just like a window where you can see what kind of companies Privanet is financing, but still, this is not so profitable business. So this maybe brings us the 10% of our sales totally. And then 50% comes from our own investments, and the rest 40% comes from the where we are financing the other companies. But if you are looking these companies which are listed on our marketplace, so you can see that it has been very successful to invest to those companies. This is like in Sweden. I think all the companies which are going to be listed, people who are working in those kind of companies, they are running the fastest time because they want to be successful. And that shows also in the how the share price goes. So if you had invested in our companies, the 15 most traded companies, which we are all 6 months, we are balancing those companies again. So you had 5 times your money back. And comparing to the Helsinki, it's more than double profits for our investors. And I think it's, like I said, it's similar to Swedish. So unlisted companies, they are very interesting ones. Of course, you have to bear in mind that there are also risks, not only the profits. Then we move now to our crowdfunding platforms, and Kasper will come to tell about those platforms more. And after the presentation, I will be also in stage to answer the questions.
Hej, god förmiddag. Jag byter över till svenska. Kasper Grönblom heter jag och som Kimmo här tidigare presenterade så har Privanet inlett ett samarbete med det bolag jag främst representerar, det vill säga Funded by Me, som är ett svenskt bolag i Finland. Men vi tar och checkar lite på de crowdfunding-verksamheter som Privanet sysslar med för tillfället främst i Finland, men där vi också kommer att expandera internationellt, framförallt via equity-crowdfundingen och möjligen också inom andra sektorer. Realinvest är den första egentliga crowdfunding-plattformen som sysslar med att belåna fastigheter. Det är en alldeles ny produkt. Den bygger på mycket av det som vi går mot inom finansiering och placering, det vill säga att man har lättare tillgänglighet till att göra placeringar och investeringar. Som bilden där visar så är den mobiloptimerad och vad man gör inom Realinvest är att vi har en fastighet som redan har etablerats, det vill säga den har grundats men söker den traditionella bankfinansieringen som i normala fall så att säga söks från en bank. Då kan fastighetsägaren söka om finansiering från Realinvest där man då lanserar det lån man vill uppta och säljer det åt egentligen oändligt många investerare som kan göra sitt beslut på minimum €25 och utan övre gräns på hur mycket man vill delta i finansierandet av fastigheten. Modellen här bygger på det att investeraren ska ha tillgång till allt som finns som byggnaden. Det finns live-kamera inne i fastigheten, direktkommunikation med bolaget som eller byggherren och 3D-modeller och så vidare. Och när det görs via den här Realinvest-plattformen som vi ser här, så har den som har investerat i lånet har egentligen en fullständig likviditet. När som helst kan han köpa och sälja sin andel av lånet i bolaget. Det här är då ett alternativ till traditionell fastighetsfinansiering, men med mycket många kryddor som gör att den blir mer den blir mer tillgänglig för även för mindre placerare, och för den som söker finansiering så är det ett mycket mer en likvid modell på det hela. Jag ska inte stanna här allt för länge. Det här hör till en av de nya grejerna inom Privanet, själv genererad, själv uppbyggd, och den första affären gjordes för bara några veckor sedan. En fastighet med en belåning på 1,6 miljoner euro. Det gick ungefär på 2 veckor så var den fullfinansierad, och problemet här var egentligen lite av ett lyxproblem. Den fylldes för snabbt på 2 veckor, så publiciteten vi fick för produkten bland sparare och placerare blev begränsad. Det var på 2 veckor så var det slut, färdig marknadsfört och fullinvesterat. Sen har vi de mer traditionella, även om man kanske inte kan kalla dem traditionella ännu, crowdfunding-plattformarna Around eller A-Round, som är startat av Privanet själv, gör equity crowdfunding i storleksklassen ungefär 1-5 miljoner euro per bolag. Vi har en mycket strikt process. Vi har många med investeringsbankbakgrund. Själv har jag revisorsbakgrund och finansierings- och buyout-bakgrund. Så det är bekanta processer som kommer ner i en lite mindre skala. Around har till dags dato gjort 20 stycken equity-rundor. Det är bolag som, och det här är endast under de senaste, sen maj 2016, så det är med en ganska god fart de görs. Här har vi dem listade. Det saknas en som stängde förra veckan. Det är då som tidigare sagt ungefär mellan 1 och 5 miljoner euro. Och här kommer vi in på det som Kimmo var inne på tidigare också i private placements. Vi har en massa bolag i Sverige, i Finland och ute i världen som behöver ta det första steget. Det sista steget så att säga inom finansbranschen kan vara det att man börslistas och klara sig på egen hand efter det. Men det första steget, det finns allmänna pengar, alltså så att säga publika pengar att söka, både lån och garantier. Det finns privata, någon har kanske en guffar eller en farbror som kan slänga in 1 miljon när man ska starta sin affärsverksamhet. Men de flesta har inte tillgång till den typen av pengar. Och då har vi en uppsamlingsplats och en funktionerande plattform för att resa pengar av den här typen. Lite närmare 36 miljoner euro har Around-plattformen rest för de här 20 bolagen till dags dato. Och processen jag var inne här på lite tidigare, för det här är ju så att Privanet verkar under Finansinspektionens regelverk, så vi har en mycket strikt kontroll på hur processerna förs och hur de dokumenteras och så vidare. Det här är en bransch som mycket lätt får smutskastning på sig om man slarvar i processerna, om man säljer icke-prima vara. Det är klart att investeraren ska alltid veta att tidigt skedes bolag och små investeringar har andra risker än etablerade bolag och större investerare med djupare fickor som kan hjälpa i ett, om det inte går enligt plan. Men vi har en ungefär på Around-sidan omkring 600 bolag per 12 månader. Nu är inte historien ännu lång. 600 bolag per 12 månader som knackar på dörren. Ungefär 100 möten med olika bolag per år. Som leder till ungefär 30 investeringsmöjligheter per år. Som då går igenom hela den här processen fram till att Privanet själv committar sig att investera 10% i bolaget, och resten av kapitalresningen sker ut till publiken och till Privanets existerande kunder. Här har vi ett exempel på ett case som nu är ute på marknaden. Det låter mycket. Får man ljudet lite längre? Det var kort. Jag kan snacka på här så. Men det går inte att skriva ner volymen. Det här är bara ett exempel på ett projekt som vi nu håller på och resa finansiering för. Det är ett miniatyrflyg, ett eldrivet flyg. Och det här är inte någon Offina-Jocke-grej precis. Han som har designat planen har 9 stycken.
The flight characteristics of the fly nano are very similar to any other small aircraft. It is stable, very easy to fly, fun and maneuverable. The sensation of the speed when you're flying close to the surface is unique. It is a plane that basically anyone can learn how to fly.
Ursäkt för den höga volymen här igen. Men det här är bara ett exempel på en produkt som inte kunde kommersialiseras utan att ha villiga, nyfikna investerare. Och som sagt, det är inte en leksak. Det är en flygplansingenjör med 9 modeller bakom sig. Den är flygtestad och den kräver inte flygcertifikat. Och där är vi mer eller mindre klara också med den finansieringen. Här har vi den produktbroschyr som jag inte behöver egentligen kommentera dess mer. Men sen till det nyaste tillskottet här. I höstas så jag och min kollega Raine här i publiken hade förra våren startade vi Funded by Me-verksamheten i Finland. Och som vi vet så har vi, eller kanske det är inte självklart, men Finansinspektionen i Finland är mycket striktare än den svenska Finansinspektionen vad gäller framförallt konsumentskydd. Så för att vara verksamma med crowdfunding i Finland så måste man ha en FSA-licens i Finland, vilket inte krävs i Sverige. Och därför så ingick vi ett samarbete med Privanet som köpte 30% av vår verksamhet i Finland. Och nu jobbar då vi under den licensen. Vi lanserar vår första kampanj för en vecka sedan precis. Och i måndags blev den full investerad på 1,2 miljoner, ett finskt media- och videosharingsbolag där framgången faktiskt var enorm. Den siffran har inte ännu publicerats, den är inte hemlig, men jag vet att Funded by Me här i Sverige och vi själv kommer att vilja publicera den och få den upp i nyheterna, för det var en stor framgång för inte bara för företagarna som fick sina pengar utan också för vi som fick arrangera det. Vi har några case som kommer ut ännu före jul som också kommer att marknadsföras i Sverige för den svenska crowdfunding-publiken. Och vi följer i Funded by Me så följer vi precis den samma processen som jag hade här på bilden tidigare. Det här i korthet är vad Privanet gör. De här senaste, min del av presentationen handlar egentligen om att visa hur åt vilket håll vi går inom finansieringen av bolag och gör det snabbare, mer mobilt och mer investerarvänligt helt enkelt. Tack.
Okay, thank you very much. Yes, we'll do a round of applause for them. Okay, so we're going to invite the floor for some questions, and when you want to ask a question, please wait for the microphone, so the ones on the webcast can hear your question too. But I'll start with a couple of questions. You showed early in the presentation your various business areas, and I'm thinking about the own investments. Could you describe maybe how the performance has been for the own investments?
Yes, like I told you, for the sales side, so if we are making 12 million euros sales this year, so maybe 60% comes from our own investments. So it has been very successful thing for us to do those. And like Kappe told us, is that Privanets is always investing to all those cases which we are crowdfunding, so that 10%. But we are not promising that we are keeping, because we are also making the markets in the secondary markets. So in bad cases, we are buying more those cases. And in good cases, we are selling those shares to the investors. So it depends of the case. Maybe the crowdfunded cases, we get maybe 10 to 20% profits from the cases. But these kind of cases, which we are going in the first place and takes the most of the risk, we are seeking for maybe 5 times profits from those cases.
Yeah, but I was thinking you showed us a performance graph of the 15 most active traders. Do you have a similar graph for the own investments, the NAV over time or something like that?
No, we haven't calculated, but I think we should. It should be, and it is very good, I think.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you said that there were 12 millions and the 60% of that was from own investments.
Yeah.
Is that revaluations or is it exit gains?
No, it is exit gains.
Pure exit gains.
Yeah.
You don't
count we don't make any valuation upsides.
Okay.
It's always the purchase value, or if we are going to put that purchase value down, like in this Lapiscate case, the analysts, they are waiting for us to put those valuations down, even what we have put that money in. Even the company is not bankrupt or something like that. So they are waiting for us that you have to lower your purchase value in that one case.
Okay, okay. Yes, I was thinking of coming back to that, but could you mention perhaps how big part that is of your NAV?
This one company?
Yeah, Lapis.
From that, Inderes is one of the biggest analyst houses in Finland, and they have expect that it is maximum 2 million euros, and that is, I have to say that is quite true.
Okay, so 2 million euros, and how much, how big part in percentage of your NAV would that be?
It depends. Like I said, there hasn't been anything why we should even do that, but we are discussing, and if we are doing, we are hoping that we don't have to even touch our estimate for this year profits. So we
How big part of your portfolio? I mean, is it 5%?
Maybe 5%. Yeah,
5%.
Yeah,
but it causes a 20% drop in the share price. Okay.
Yeah,
sure. Do we have any questions from the audience? We have one over here.
I just wonder about this Real Invest or Real Invest. Who is the client? Is it the builder of the building, or is it the future proprietor that is the client?
The primary client is the builder. And then what I didn't mention here is that the loan is always a secured loan. It can be a first priority secured loan, or a secondary secured loan if there is also bank finance in the financing structure. But the client who comes to seek for the funding is the builder. And then the exit for those who participate in the Real Invest typically is expected pretty soon, because when the building is ready, it's ready, and then almost by definition, then you have institutions and banks who want to finance it through a sort of normal loan, and that's when they replace the bridging provided by Real Invest.
Okay, I'll follow up with another question. Looking at the other business outside of your own investments, you say that around 40% is this financing operations. Could you elaborate a bit on how you make money here, and what is it? 40%, is that all fees and commissions, or and what level are those fees at?
Yeah. If we take the this one. So, like I told, from the fee side, so of course, when we are investment service company, so we are getting our fees from the companies who are seeking money. So in real estate, it is depending of the how much securities is behind the project, but this is something like 2-4% the fee, and it comes directly from the constructor, not from the investor. So investors doesn't pay anything for us. Then in the equity crowdfunding, the normal fee at the moment in Finland is something between 5-8%. And we are, with our success rate, it is so high. So we are at the moment in the highest level. So we are between 8-10%. And we really have to choose the cases which we can put on live, because we are just picking one in 1 month. So those companies are not fighting to get to our crowdfunding platform, but still they are really looking forward to come there. And that's why it is, they are calculating that, okay, it's better to pay 10% to them or to us, or to pay somebody 5%, and they can't be sure that they are getting the money. So that's the money price. And in private placement, it is like, I think in 5% is the fee at the moment in Finland.
Okay.
And in secondary markets, if you are buying or selling your shares, it's 2% trade fee.
2% trade fee.
Yeah.
And I was thinking also about that. What is the average spread or something like that? Is it a liquid market, so to speak? Or do you act as market maker here?
Like I showed, there are a couple of good companies where are very good liquidity. So you can sell your shares or buy your shares in one every day. But in most of the cases, I think those 15 companies which were in that index, they are quite liquid ones. So you can get your money back if you are selling in a few days, and if you are buying, you might have to wait, because there are more, we need more sellers than buyers, because people are just waiting that they could buy. And that's also why there are not so big spreads at all, because the buyers are willing to pay almost anything to get those companies.
But you know yourselves don't act as market makers in these
markets? No.
Okay.
We are only because we can buy. So if there are no investors buying, and somebody still wants to sell, and we think that, okay, now there are no investors at the buy side, so we can go to the buy side and say to the seller that, okay, now we are here, we are willing to buy those shares, so if it's okay for you to sell those shares to us, so then it's okay for us to buy those shares.
Do you have any questions from the floor? No. Well, a follow-up on this graph that you showed on the 15 most active traded companies. What would that graph look like if you took all or the 49 companies and equal weighted them?
I think it would be looking quite similar to this one. The only thing is that now it's quite like you can see, there has been liquidity. It is making those graph movements. But if there would be 40 more companies without so much liquidity, so it would be like making not so many movements. But still, those companies which are in our marketplace, we are choosing that there can't be companies which might go bankruptcy. So we are quite selective, which we take there, and we are not getting any money from the companies which are listed in our marketplace, but we are getting money if somebody wants to get there. We don't want that company, so then we would say that, okay, this costs too much for you, so you can't come. So we have been very selective with this one.
And just one last question on the general rationale of your business. I was thinking, running your own portfolio and raising money for other companies, Is there really a rationale for keeping this as a group, or have you considered separating the different entities into different entities?
I think it's very good combination, and I think it somebody else is also they, and I know that our competitors in Finland, they would like to do it like we are doing, but the FSA license to do this, our model is too expensive for them, so that's why they are not doing like that. So the thing is that if you are saying that, okay, I'm investing to these companies with same terms than other investors, of course, we are looking the terms very well, and because we are stock exchange listed company, we are seeking profits, so that should be very good investment also for the investors. So I think this is very good combination. The secondary market side is the only thing what we have been thinking that, okay, it's not so good business, but of course we know that investors, they have to have the possibility to sell also those shares. So that's why we are keeping that also in our group, but that is not so profitable.
Have you run into any incidents or conflicts of interests with investors or stuff like that?
No, not really. Of course, we are, FSA is looking always this one. It is of course something what we have to be care of every day. So we can't do that. That was the reason why I said that, okay, if somebody is selling their shares, so we have to tell that, okay, now we are coming to buy those, and there can't be any other investors same side on the table that they can't buy first. So we always have to wait for the investors to do something first, and after that we can come to the table.
Okay, if there are no closing questions from the floor, then I suggest we thank Kimmo and Kasper with a warm applause.
Thank you.